Our Arturo Marquez and Giovanni Marquez are both young fighters, and I caught up with them. Check it out. Like, whose style does he fight?
Alexis Arguello.
Really?
Yeah, because my dad, he makes him study fights. You know, my dad's like an old school, you know, Alexis Arguello, Carlos Zarate, Salvador Sanchez. There you go. See, they watch, because they watch them. They're little, they don't know about these fighters, but they know them because of my dad sits them down. Look, I want you guys to fight like this. I don't want you guys to get hit like your dad used to get hit. Better defense. No, really, it's the truth.
That's
better
the sweet defense. Science.
No, doesn't Tito tell you that?
To box.
Yeah, to box. To box. And, you know, actually what happened, and let me say that, let me reword that. When I was an amateur, I was a good technician. I was in and out fighter. But when I signed with Lou Duva, and now after many years, I could say that. Because you know what? I'm retired. I can say whatever I want. Whoever doesn't like it, then it kiss my ass. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Reality TV, baby. Hey, listen. If you follow me in amateurs, I was a real good amateur fighter. I mean, just look, ask people about it. All right, I turned pro. The Duvas, Lou Duva, and I used to train here in San Antonio. Joe Sousa's gym, the late Joe Sousa, Leija, Renaud Whitaker. We also have training camp here, Arturo Gatti, Andrew Galata.
I met him in Galata in training camp in Orlando.
Yeah, we used to have camp here at, what's the name of the gym, Lupe?
San Fernando?
San Fernando Valley Gym, yeah, years ago. So anyways, the Duvas...
You got enough tape in that thing? Because he's on the roll, man.
The Duvas used to watch me fight... Lou Duva used to watch me fight Tony Ayala. Torito Tony Ayala. And, you know, he was a plotter, flat-footed. Boom. Boom. Dig to the body. So that... I became that kind of fighter. You know, how do you do that? I mean, because people ask, why did you allow him to do that? Well, you know the boxing world. Like, they got my dad over to the side, and they brought in the trainers. And back then... No disrespect to nobody, Georgie Benton, with Ronnie Shields, Roger Bloodworth, they were all part of the Duva team. So that's the style the new Duva wanted me to fight. Forward, body puncher, but that really wasn't my style. It really wasn't. But when they're giving you money, and I'm young, they're giving you a nice rental car, and they're buying you clothes, they're buying everything you want. You have no room, you ain't gotta say nothing. You're eating around, you go to training camp in Houston, San Antonio, you're sitting down with Pernell Whitaker, Evander Holyfield, Meldrick Taylor, you're having dinner with them guys. Hey, I mean, they developed this guy, so what room do I have to say? Even though I was a good amateur, I have to go by what they're saying. So anyways, that changed my whole style, why.
So let me ask you this, who are you guys' favorite trainers today in the game of boxing? Who do you enjoy from the trainers?
That's a tough question. I respect a trainer. No disrespect to any of the top trainers. Okay, I respect a trainer that brings a kid from the bottom, like this kid, and makes him blossom all the way to the top.
Like Joe Goosen with the Ruelas brothers, from 5 years old to world champion.
That is the kind of guys you really respect. The kind of fighters trainers that get a fighter already made. I mean, you know. They're already made. I mean, but if they could, if they've had problems, like, you know, Kelly Pavlik, he made that big change. He had to move out of Youngstown, whatever problems he was having over there. Now he's over here in a total different environment. The Mexican Freddy Roach, Robert Garcia, you know?
Yeah.
And now he's, you know, I mean, Donaire, Antonio Margarito, his brother Mikey. Who else is he training?
Bam Bam.
Bam Bam Rios, Brandon Rios. So he's done good for himself. Now, if he could... turn Pavlik's career around, you know, then that, you know, you gotta give the kid, the guy credit.
We'll find out. Now, really quick, You guys are gonna laugh. Standing near me, two of the biggest fans of Robert Garcia you'll ever meet on the planet. I did a video about them, I uploaded it to YouTube. The comments are redneck Mexicans, groupies. What else do they call you? Every bad name.
Crackheads.
Wow.
Because they really love Robert.
Those are respectful nicknames they got
going. Yeah, Robert's done, I mean, he's done great for himself. I'm glad that everybody has a niche for something, you know. I mean, he was a world champion, decent amateur, but I think he's blossomed more as a trainer. You know,
he's very young.
And he's young, you know. I mean, who would have thought, like, I've been doing a lot of broadcasting. I've gotten lucky, too. I've gotten a lot of work, and I'm getting better at it. I'm learning as I go. And who knows what it could blossom into. So, you know, I can't complain. Because a lot of fighters after boxing, not everybody makes the millions that Pacquiao makes and Mayweather makes. We all know that. Less than 1%, man, of the fighters. And the ones that do make the money, they lose it. I mean, they go, that's the truth.
You know? I know an NBA player who made $10 million. Saw me, he said, hey, Ellie, you got $20 to lend me? I'm like, what happened to your money? He goes, oh, I bought cars, I partied, I bought a record label, I lost everything. And even there's a boxer like that who got $4.5 million and lost everything. Last time I saw him, yes, like, it happens.
It happens, man. It happens to a lot of our fighters. You know, I could honestly say, like, from my, you know, my Olympic team, you know, not mentioning any names, but I'm maybe like two or three of us are the golden boy. I mean, you know, he's very well off. I'm sure Chris Bird, you know, he was a heavyweight. He made decent money. And I consider myself that I'm good, you know, because I save some of my money from fighting and I'm making money doing broadcasting. So I live well, you know, I live well.
One of my favorite quotes is, you know, I spent my money on wine and women and the rest I just wasted.
That's a good investment.
There you go. I'm sorry to interrupt my son's interview.
So
but
if Manny Pacquiao fights Floyd Mayweather, who would you recommend me to put my money on?
Floyd Mayweather.
Why?
He's fast. I think he's faster, stronger, and he moves around a lot. And I think Pacquiao have trouble trying to hit him with good, clean shots.
Especially after the last Marquez fight, you think trouble. But now Pacquiao has a very tough fight, June 9th, against Bradley.
I think Pacquiao will beat him.
You think what do you think? Who wins?
Pacquiao.
It'll be an interesting fight. We're gonna have to see how Pacquiao comes back from the Marquez fight. Because actually, I worked that fight, not taking anything away from Pacquiao. I called it 115-113 for Marquez, and I said, you know, when I did it on HBO Sat, I said, not because my last name is Marquez or because I'm Mexican, but I had Marquez winning by 2 points. So let's see how Manny comes back from this, and especially with all the distractions in his life. I mean, it's hard. I mean, the guy's a superstar. He's wanted everywhere, and it's hard to stay at a high level, you know, at the pace that he's going. And he's been in a lot of wars, too, so it'll be interesting.
What do you think?
Well, you know, I think you got pure aggression against, you know, flawless boxing, and that's what boxing's all about. You know, boxing's supposed to beat pure aggression every single time. So I think if you have to put your money on it, I think you got to look at it that way. And it's, I mean, you got to go with Floyd.
Floyd beats Manny.
I would say so, but I mean, I think he'll have some tough moments. But I think that's where the smart money should be.
Yeah, Floyd. I mean, he's a counterpuncher, man. He's gonna counterpunch Manny to death. If Marquez was able to do it at his age, he's a lot slower. Can you imagine what Pacquiao, Mayweather could do?
I've seen him train. This guy, 2 in the morning, he shows up at the Goosen Gym in the middle of the night. They open up the gym, he just trains for 3 hours, no breaks, 5-minute rounds.
Yeah, I seen some of his camp, too, when he was going to fight Mosley. And the guys just kept bringing him in. 5-minute rounds, sometimes just a little water break, or sometimes no rest at all. It's crazy.
Mountain Dew.
I never seen a guy train like that. I mean, much respect for him.
Maybe. So, last question. What message do you have for people who hopefully in 5-6 years will see this video and say, wow, that's the guy when he was a kid? What would you tell them now?
That if they're doing boxing, to stick with it. But if it's something that they do not want to do, go to school, college, and hopefully be successful in that.
Wise words, very wise words. So there you have it. Stay tuned for more in San Antonio, Texas, for EastonReporting.com. I'm Melissa Beck reporting.